Hey everyone, I recently wrote a blog on my blog, obscurenarration.com, talking about how to set up a WordPress server on my LAN. That way I can syndicate files to my iPhone. And as you know, or a lot of you know, the Linux desktop isn't necessarily the best desktop for interfacing with an iOS device. So what I wanted to do was be able to download YouTube videos or Twitch videos or maybe some movies that I own and be able to send them over to my iPhone for a trip that I had coming up. But I couldn't just plug my phone into my computer and be able to transfer them over. Now, there's a lot of different ways that you can do this, and you can be subscribed to a whole bunch of different services. I could set up a Plex server. I could be subscribed to Spotify and Google Music for music offline mode. Obviously, podcasts are made for offline mode. I could be, there's ones from Netflix where there's certain movies that you're allowed to download for offline mode, but I didn't want to have to pay for a whole bunch of different services in order to have things in offline mode on my phone for while I'm on the plane. And I also like to play around with some stuff. And so the idea came to me, it's like, well, hey, why not set up a Linux server, install WordPress, and then use that to syndicate the files from my local server to my iPhone. Now, this works with pretty much any podcatcher that lets you put in a custom URL. It didn't work for me with Pocket Cast because Pocket Cast wants to check against its own database of active podcasts, but the stock podcast app on the iPhone and then also any of the podcatchers that were for Android seemed to work okay except for Pocket Cast. Obviously, the best one I would use on Android would be AntennaPod. So that one, I know for sure that one works, and I was able to use that even on my Amazon Fire tablet, where I sideloaded the AntennaPod app onto it and then was able to use it. So this will work with any podcatcher, but particularly this was for me, was to get files from my Linux desktop over to my iPhone and then just be able to drop them in, it would automatically download them, and then I could use the podcatcher. So I listen to a lot of my podcasts at 1.5 speed, like 1.25, 1.5 speed. Sometimes I like to watch just regular TV shows and movies at a little bit faster speed. That way I can see, I can get through the whole movie on an airplane. If it's a 3-hour, or let's say this flight was a 2-hour flight and the movie's 2 hours and 15 minutes, it'd be nice to kind of bump that speed up, be able to get the whole movie done. So that's the reason why I set this up. But there is a whole bunch of different ways. I'm going to go through really quickly on how to set this up. Then at the end, I'll come back and talk about why and how well it worked and everything. So if you just want to see how to set it up, we're going to get that out of the way right away. What I am using is just straight from my blog. I already wrote down all the commands that you need to run. So I'm just going to do a lot of copy and paste from my blog on how to set it up. And what I've also done is I use PHP VirtualBox to manage my virtual servers on my network. The reason why I use it is just because it comes with FreeNAS. I could just put together a jail, install PHP VirtualBox, and away I go. It only takes a few seconds. So yeah, this is probably an older version of PHP VirtualBox. It's probably not the best way to handle virtual servers. There's all kinds of different ways to do it. This is just the easiest for me. This is what works for me. I also run a firewall on my network, so I block a lot of that stuff from being able to access the outside internet. What I'm doing here in VirtualBox inside of PHP VirtualBox is I just have a stock Ubuntu 14.04 server, and then I've just cloned it to make a new one. I have that one up and running. There's lots of great guys out there on setting up an Ubuntu server. And yes, I'm running an old 14.04. You can get 16.04. And if I had 16.04, I could probably use like LXC, LXD. I could use Docker. I could use Snaps. There's all kinds of stuff that I could use to maybe even make it easier for the virtualization. But I'm just going to clone this server and I'm just going to use it this way because it's not using that much resources. It's a single core processor, 512 megabytes of RAM and 20 gigabytes of storage. Sounds an awful lot like a lot of the VPSs that you can get out there. So if you're on DigitalOcean or something like that, it'd be the same kind of hardware specs that you would get from that. I have plenty of capacity on my server, so this is just how I'm going to set it up. So how I'm going to get started here is after I've turned that on, I'm just going to SSH into that server, which is what I've already done here. And then I need to install some PHP modules. I'll download the WordPress tar file. I'll set some permissions and then I'll pretty much be done. So I'm going to go through this whole setup. So if you never installed WordPress before, this might help you on getting it set up. So the first thing I'm going to do is install some PHP modules and then we'll be able to get this going. So I'm just going to paste that in and all this stuff installs pretty quickly. There's nothing that takes a whole bunch of time here. And so that's really why I'm going to go through this just step by step on how to get this done, because it really does install pretty quickly. after the PHP modules are installed that WordPress needs, I'm then going to download WordPress, move it over to the web server, and then set some permissions. So once this is done, we will download the latest WordPress server. And then when this is all done, I am going to block this from getting access to the internet. So that's why I'm going to cut corners, and I haven't shown any like how to set up deny hosts or any other server hardening. I'm not going through and doing any of that. So again, if you were to have this on the open web, make sure to harden your Linux server, because otherwise people could get access pretty easily. Okay, now this is done, I'm just going to download into my home directory here the latest version of WordPress, which is actually pretty small. And then I will untar it and then move it over to the web server. So you can see now I have my file, and then I'm going to move it over to the web server. You could copy it. You could make multiple temp directory if you wanted to and save it to there, and then just copy it over. But you can see now I've downloaded it. The folder has been moved over to the Apache web server. So that's pretty much it. I'm going to set a few permissions in here where I'm going to set the web server as the owner of the file just recursively through all the folders. And then I'm going to do the same thing with the permissions to allow write access. So this is where, again, just going to make it totally clear, I cut a lot of corners here. I didn't set up any extra security. I just gave write permissions to basically everyone, and then, or at least myself, and then set the owner to the web server, which is totally fine. But I didn't do any other security stuff in here. So again, if you're making it open to on the open internet, you got a lot more security stuff to do here. But because I'm blocking it, I'm not going to do any of that stuff. So now that all the permissions are set and the write access is set, I'm going to go in here and create the SQL database. And so I'm going to go in as root on my SQL, and then I'm going to create a database. I'm just calling it WordPress. And then I'm going to give it all privileges with the user identified by a password. It's a pretty lame password. But again, I'm not accessing it from the open internet, or I'm not allowing it to be on the open internet. I'm going to flush the privileges, and then I'm going to quit. And so now I have my folder. I have my WordPress database set up, and I've given it a user. And so now I'm just going to add those database credentials into the WordPress folder, into the INI file, and then I'm going to go change my maximum upload. So now that all of my user permissions are set and my write access is changed, so all my permissions are set up, I'm going to copy the sample configuration file to the regular configuration file. Then I'm going to go in and I'm going to edit that config file with my SQL database information. So I've already copied over to the new file. And so now I'm just going to go in here and I'm going to use Nano. Come at me. I know a lot of discussion out there about which text editor I like to use, but I'm just going to use Nano to edit it. And I know there's a lot of people probably cringing, and they see all how my write permissions are set up. So that's not, as I said, on my LAN, it's not open to anyone else. And the files that I'm going to change here, so I'm going to define the database, which I had called WordPress, and then I'm going to set the password for it. So we have WordPress, SQL database username was WordPress, and then I have my password. I'm going to edit here, which was my WordPress password is what I had it set as when I created that WordPress database. Write it out, exit, and now I'm going to restart the web server and MySQL. So I'm going to restart Apache. Whoops. Let's use the right interface here. So Apache 2, let's restart that. And let's restart SQL after this is done. So let's restart that. And so now the WordPress, your WordPress installation should be ready to go. You could just go to the IP address. And this one is just /WordPress because that's the name of our folder. And you just have to do the last of the configuration stuff for WordPress. So it's going to ask some questions what the site title is. So I'm just going to call it podcast RSS. Going to set my user. Let's set this password to something just really easy. And you can turn on, set the email. So my email at my email.com. It doesn't really matter what any of this is. Confirm my weak password. And so it's just as long as I have my username and password set up correctly. That way I can get into it. Because what I'm going to do is I'm going to set all of the posts to go into the really simple podcast extension. And then, so I just need to be able to log into this. So Dominic and my password. And that's it. WordPress is all set up. Before I block it from getting outside internet access, I'm going to install one plugin. And that plugin is what I'm using to syndicate the RSS to set up the podcast feed. And this is called Seriously Simple Podcasting. So in the plugins, I'm going to add a new and search for Seriously Simple Podcasting. Seriously Simple Podcasting. Where are you? Seriously Simple Podcasting. Here it is right there. I don't need any of this other stuff because it's just my personal feed. So now, once that's done installing, I'll be able to go activate it and then configure it. Go into the settings and configure anything that I want to set up. This is just an ad. So now that I have my WordPress instance set up and I've installed the add-on for the syndication for the RSS feed reader, the only thing I need to do is I need to go into settings and go to permalinks and just change it to plain permalinks. You could set it up to have the pretty URLs and you could go configure your server to allow those. I don't really care in this instance. So I'm just going to set it to plain. And if I go back to my podcast settings, I could change what the post type is, where I want it to display. If I want it in the main feed, set all that stuff up. And then if you go to publishing, you'll be able to see this complete feed URL right here. That's what you're going to add to your podcatcher on your phone or on your desktop or whatever app that you're using. That's the URL that you're going to use. And so in this, like, you'll be able to see when I click on it, I have my RSS feed. And so that's pretty much it. Everything else is set up. The only last thing that you need to do before you're all done is you need to go change the max upload file size and the max post size. Because what I found is that when you have a video, when you have like a movie or you have a Twitch download that you've saved, the file size is actually pretty big. So you'll want to make sure that you increase the file size limit that is allowed. By default, PHP is set to 2 megabytes, which obviously isn't anything. It's just for text posts, essentially. It's the max upload file size. So you'll want to set that. I've set mine to 1 gigabyte, but I just got back from a trip and I realized that 1 gigabyte isn't actually big enough. I set it to 2 gigabytes. You can set it for as big as you want to. The only thing that you have to keep in mind is how much room you have on your phone and then how much room you have on your server. My server's got 20 gigabytes of storage. And so I just have to keep in mind how many files I throw at it, especially if I'm throwing, say, 2, 3, 4 gigabyte file sizes onto the server, that I'm going to run out of room pretty quickly. So that's the last thing you need to do. That's here in the blog, too, that you'd go edit the php.ini file. And then that would, you go in there and you set the max upload size. Upload max. I always get those ones backwards. So upload max. And you set that, like this one set for 1 gigabyte. We're going to set the post max size. And you can see that's 1 gigabyte as well. And then I'm going to change the max execution time. So if we search for that, you can see I've set it to just 10,000. So I just want to give it as much time as it needs because file sizes can be pretty big. But after I write this out and I exit out of Nano, I restart the Apache server, and over on your podcatcher or your pod syndication server, once you go to media and you go to upload a new file, you'll see that the maximum upload file size now is 1 gigabyte or 2 gigabytes or 4 gigabytes or however much room that you set it. So, and that's it. That's it to all this setting up to it. You set up the LAMP server, the Ubuntu server with a LAMP stack, and then you install WordPress. You move it over to the web server. You change some configuration files, and that's pretty much it. You add the extension in. The last thing that I'll just mention, again, for like the third or fourth time, I know it's getting repetitive in this video, but it's got to make sure that if you have this open to the public internet, that you, there's a lot of security settings that you need to save here. This is just on my LAN, and so you can see over on my firewall, I'll go to the IP address. This is my RSS test server, and I'm going to just tell it to dump any connections to the internet. So if I go now to my server and I try and ping something, it's not allowed to have access to the internet, and so I'm not worried about those security concerns. So that's it. That's everything is set up. So when I'm on my LAN and I open up the podcast app on my phone, which is what I'm going to pull up right now, when I go into it, you'll see that I have a feed already set up. So if I go to my podcast and see, there's my feeds, and I have my podcasts that are in there, and then I can watch them on my phone, and or I can watch the video if I wanted to. So here comes a video up right now, and then I can change the maximum speed, so I can watch stuff in a little bit faster if I wanted to. So if there was a movie or something like that, or even just a podcast, I can add to it. And this also means that all of my stuff is in a single repository. So my regular podcasts and the podcasts that come from my own personal server can all be in one single place instead of having multiple apps. And that's what I wanted to close out here on, was why would I set something up like this? There's obviously lots of services that you can pay for. You can set up an MB or a Plex server. Then you can make that access. You can set files to be set for offline mode. You can download them to your phone. Yes, you can set that up. And actually have a Plex server already running. I don't pay for the Plex Pass, so I can't do things in offline mode. So, but you could do that. And you could accomplish the same type of stuff. You can move things over. You could be subscribed to YouTube Red. You could be subscribed to Spotify for offline mode. Almost all the media apps now have an offline mode. So you could definitely do that if you're willing to pay for all of the subscriptions to be able to do that. For me, I just wanted to be able to watch some YouTube or Twitch videos while I was on the road without having to pay for a bunch of services. And this gave me an excuse to go mess around with a Linux server and install WordPress. So there's nothing fancy here. It's just something I thought was interesting. I wanted to give you a hands-on demo on how quickly it can be set up. I'm going to delete this server because I already have one running that I piggybacked on another WordPress instance that's running my recipe server. So, and that's going to be it for this time. I hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to leave me a comment in below if you have any questions on how to get this set up, or if you noticed something that maybe there's a different way. I'd like to hear from you if there was a way that you would set this up, or what else you would use it for besides, say, YouTube or Twitch videos or movies that you may own or something like that. Is there something else that you would use it for? Let me know in the comments below. Let me know on Twitter at domcorriveau, or email me dominic.corriveau@gmail.com and put DC Talks into the subject line. That way I know you're coming from YouTube. Be sure to check out the other videos on my channel, and I'll catch you all next time.